Hello, Niklas. Welcome again to the Data 2020 Summit. It's really a pleasure having you here today, and thank you for your input to the summit. So before we dive into the questions, can you tell us more about your background and your area of expertise?
Sure, I can. Thank you. I'm Niklas Johansson, and I've been working in different consultants and businesses and in the area of business intelligence, data warehousing and analytics for about 20 years now. So I've been around in quite many organizations working with about the same issues, distributing data to the right person in the right time.
So quite an experience. today you are presenting on becoming a data-driven organization. And you spoke about actually what does that mean? Can you tell us a little bit more about it in a short summary, let's say?
Yeah, sure. I'll try to summarize. It's quite a complex area.
Yes.
As we tend to have all the data in different silos and different systems, and usually it's very hard to get the data from there. And today, everyone needs data to make a better decision. And it's hard to get data from another part of the organization. And I think that is the key that we are working with right now. Because everyone in the organization needs to be independent and take their own decisions, because you cannot ask someone else, what should I do today? And you want to improve your business and be more efficient. So everyone needs the data then to take the best decision possible.
So speaking of becoming data-driven, as you describe it, so where is it that companies should start? As you said, it's a very complex process. Where
Correct.
Do they need to start from?
I think you must look for data as an asset, as everyone talks about right now, and what does that actually mean?
Yes.
Well, you should not build a system and then ask yourself, what data do I need for a system? You should start with the information. What information do I have? And what are the processes that need the data? And then build a system for supporting that process.
So while we're on it, what would be some of the mistakes, some of the pitfalls, let's say, that organizations should avoid when embarking in this journey, in becoming data driven?
I think one of the biggest is that you think technology will solve your problems. It is more of a mindset, a cultural set in the organization rather than buying a new technology or a new product. There are lots of suppliers in the area and they all have great products. But if you don't handle the data correct, you will not benefit from their products in the best way. So you need to get every person in the organization to understand the data they need and what data there is and how to handle it and treat it right.
And hold them accountable. Thank you very much, Niklas. It was really a pleasure having you today. Thank you for this interview.
Thank you very much. Yeah.